Juan Inavicia Luna was born on October 23, 1857, in Badog, Ilocos Norte, in the Philippines. He is the third son among seven of Joaquin Luna de San Pedro y Posada and Loriana Navicio y Ancheta. Luna was an Ilocano painter, a sculptor, and a political activist of the Philippine Revolution in the late 19th century. But most of his remaining works are his paintings, which made him to be one of the first Filipinos who excel and earn recognition in the international field of arts and culture. His movements were Romanticism and Impressionism. This is because he was influenced by the art employed by the Spanish conquerors who dominated the Philippines for 333 years. The Spanish used art as a form of their communication to the Filipinos in introducing Catholicism and Spanish culture 3 centuries before Luna was born. Moreover, Luna became more exposed to the Renaissance painters when one of his Spanish friends named Don Alejo Vera commissioned and brought him to Rome for further studies. In fact, Luna's painting styles illustrate the influence of Delacroix, Lumiere, and Rembrandt. Since then, Luna's works were done in Spanish and French styles. He painted literary and historical scenes that depict political commentary that are inspired with classical ballads and often show figures in theatrical poses. Most of Juan Luna's work of art won numerous awards. These major works include, for example, the most popular one, the painting entitled Spolarium, that received a gold medal in the Exposición Nacional de Bellas Artes in Madrid. It generally depicts the defeated gladiators that are being dragged into a pile of other corpses in the Roman arena. On the left, there are many spectators with a variety of expressions, while on the far right, there is a grieving woman in torn and shabby clothing. There is also a governing use of red, mostly in the center, that contradicts to the woman's blue dress. This contradiction of colors used by Luna has a symbolic value. It means that the Philippines was treated unequally by the Spanish government at that time. Next is the Interior de un Café, or simply Inside the Café, which won silver medal in the World Fair St. Louis Exposition in the U.S. This is also called the Parisian Life, for it was created by Luna in his Parisian period of 8 years, meaning it was the time when his style became increasingly lighter in color and in wood. This painting portrays a glimpse of Luna's life while he was in Paris together with his two other important Filipino friends. It is said to be that they are the ones who are sitting in the left side of the painting while looking at the woman who is identified as a prostitute representing fallen womanhood. Like this Spolarium, the Parisian Life also mirrors the status of the Philippines under the Spanish government. This can be seen through the woman who represents the Philippines. As we look closely, the woman has a dark neck that seems like it is connected with the window joint line that looks like the woman is being strangled. It conveys that the Philippines was under stress at that moment. Thirdly is the España y Filipinas, or the Spain and the Philippines. It is one of the enduring pieces of legacy that the Filipinos inherited from Luna. It is an allegorical depiction of two women who are walking together, which represents Spain and the Philippines. The Spaniard woman, or the Mother Spain, is drawn with wide, strong shoulders, while the Filipina is illustrated as graceful and brown-skinned lady. They are both wearing dresses that are known as traje de mestizas, or the dress of the mestiza. From here, the difference between the cultural and social status of the two women at that time is very visible. If we will notice, the two women are heading their backs towards a faraway horizon, which portrays that Spain was leading the Philippines into the path of progress and development. Although it projects a close bond between the two countries through feminine figures, the painting was a propaganda that revealed hope and desires of the Filipinos to be free from the Spanish colony. The Filipinos were longing for reform, equality, modernization, and economic improvement. The fourth one is the El Pacto de Sangre, or the Blood Compact, that won first prize at the St. Louis Exposition in the U.S. It is an historical painting portraying the blood compact between Raja Sikatuna of the Philippines and Miguel Lopez de Legazpi of Spain. The fifth one is the La Batalla de Lepanto, or the Battle of Lepanto of 1571. It is another historical painting that is considered as one of the huge epic canvases that Luna had made. In fact, it became a gold medalist in 1888 Fine Arts Exhibition in Barcelona. It provides significance to the Spanish victory against the Moors. Then Luna also received a silver medal in the National Exposition of Fine Arts in Madrid because of his painting called La Muerte de Cleopatra, or The Death of Cleopatra. Lastly, there is Las Damas Romanas, or The Roman Dames, that is awarded with a Diploma of Honor at the Munich Salon Masterpiece of Classic Work. Besides those major pieces made by Juan Luna, there are other artworks of his that are exhibited in the different museums found in the Philippines and in some places in Europe, specifically in Spain. And although Luna had died on December 7, 1899, he remained alive in the Filipinos' hearts, for he left a great legacy that will never be perished when it comes not only in the field of arts and culture, but also for being a brave hero of his own country. Again, that was Juan Luna.